This is Stoshi's Treasure Hunters, and I'm Hirosha Sharp. So this is the weekly hunt update. There hasn't been much going on with the hunt. It's kind of slowed down because of the Tezo mini hunt, and because of the university tour that they're doing, they're focusing, I guess, obtaining new hunters. At the end of the video, I'll have the three keys that have been released with that new clue drop that occurred earlier in the week. Which wasn't really much of a clue drop, as more of a continuation. I tried to do a video a couple different times and my audio just sucks and I have to redo just my whole video editing setup. basically working on a very old computer that's basically 12 years old and it's time for an upgrade. It's just, I've done all the modifications I can, so I'm going to have to basically get a new computer, you know, a new motherboard, go from a Pentium 3 to, I don't know, maybe a 5 or a 7, you know. Really, really working the old school here. Maybe upgrade to 16 gigs so I can do video editing. But there's a couple things that happened or haven't happened. Eric the game maker hasn't done his D-Live where he was going to kind of talk about the public key and the state of the game. That hasn't happened yet. Nor the blog he promised earlier about the hunted. Yeah, things have been really slow on that end. I will have a link at the end of the video to SD News Hunt where he talked about the business card he received and what it looks like. And if you go to the Telegram chat, there is a disclosure there where some of the hunters were able to kind of figure out what the SD News Hunt's, not SD News Hunt, but the Satoshi Hunter's emails could potentially be. I'll have a link to that in the show notes, but for the most part there really hasn't been any movement. Things have really slowed down. People are working on other hunts to kind of keep their brain going, and it's just a little weird and a little disappointing. It kind of sucks, really. You know, I've been a big advocate of them just, you know, dropping 5-10 keys. People feel a little miffed because they feel like they're trying to bring on new hunters instead of, you know, working with the current, you know, hunters have been with the game for a long while. but yeah, so there has been some, like I said, there has been some news. Like, you know, there's University Part 2, which is an ongoing tour. They've been disclosing key drops each day at these different universities. We don't get any heads up, so you have to kind of go after the fact a little bit, after their talks or whatever. I have a link to the cooperative group that they have, again, in the show notes, and the three different pictures, so you have an idea what the keys look like. They kind of look neat, the flyers. They have, like, the college little cap on the Satoshi Hunter's face and the QR codes and stuff like that. I do want to give a shout-out to Evers8. I think I'm saying his user's name right. He did help with the Tezo mini hunt solution about the different hashes, like, the first hash for that particular, the Tezo mini hunt, led to the smart contracts. That's what the Tezo system is based off smart contracts. That first hash, if you're trying to solve for yourself, and something to keep in your toolkit, is potentially something when they do release that game, that might be something that you need to learn how to do. Is you go to that, take that hash, and you find the smart contract. And then for the smart contract, you got these six other codes, and you had a hash that led you to a geolocation in Shanghai. And I have a link from the Telegram of the Twitter of that QR code. So if you found the other QR codes, even though the puzzle has been solved, at least you had that for your collection and kind of figure out that skill set of going for the smart contract from that hash to hashing those coordinates and and then finding the geolocation to the Shanghai location. And again, this would be good for your application if you're going to participate in the Tezo hunt to be able to read smart contracts and figuring that out. The comments is on the Tezo mini hunt, ever as I put that there. And I'll have a link to the final Twitter tweet out of the final Tezo QR code. So if you had 014, you'd be able to piece all those together and at least find the address and see for yourself, like, hey, I saw this, I can do this. And then just kind of pull that information, your skills that you learned on the way, and put it in, like, a nice little toolbox to learn how to do, and might be a good reference point to whenever the Tezo hunt itself launches. As far as the Satoshi's treasure hunt, like I said, it's really focusing on the university tours. There hasn't been like a really like puzzle clue drop in, let me check the date as a recording. I'm recording this on the 11th of October. Let me pull up the Satoshi site. So the last puzzle key was 922. That was a really long time ago. So like almost 20 days ago. The university key, the second part, dropped on the 8th, which was 2 days ago. And then the 24th was when the first university key dropped. So it's been a really huge gap in between these puzzles, if you will. I know a lot of people don't really like the geolocation ones. I kind of do, but I understand people's frustrations. I think if the momentum of the game had stayed consistently, where people, public or private clans, were much larger, they would be able to network and be able to reach out at a much easier pace to go, like, ping people and be like, hey, Japan Wing, there's a geolocation in your region. Is there somebody that can get to that QR code? Or China or India or any of these locations. Now that the groups have contracted and got smaller because the interest has waned because of the fact that the clues have not dropped as rapidly as they should for a game that's supposed to take a year, it's much harder to do these geolocation games. Another thing that happened, and no one's really sure if it's true or not, is that somebody had won a key from the was it the Zero Knowledge Hackathon with Coinless. They were able to sell their key through the Telegram channel, which is, again, something that's supposed to be part of the game, or a marketplace where certain keys people can sell or exchange in some fashion. That was done, the person sold it. But I still think it's kind of early, considering that right now we're sitting around 65 keys or so, and there's supposed to be 1,000 keys. But again, people are trying to rack them up to get to that 400 number, that magic number. It's been 6 months since the game has launched. It's supposed to take another year. So I'm not calling this game broken or not. I just don't think that it's being done well enough for the level or caliber of players that first joined the game and the expectation that people had for this game. I'm still playing along, trying to learn and stuff like that, but I just really don't know at this point about this game, of just how serious the game makers were when they initially launched, if they planned this well enough through for to keep the level of interest of the players, to keep the momentum going, to keep people engaged, to kind of honor what they promise about, you know, the different level of prizes, game puzzles, and even the little mini hunts, you know, where people can win some Bitcoin and stuff like that, which is part of the university one. The first university key, that was solved. Basically, what it was like from the initial four colleges that were given, there was like 5 QR codes on each campus. You had to take those 5 QR codes, combine them together, and drain the 0.05 of Bitcoin from that wallet, and that was drained. We don't know if it was done by the game makers or done by somebody who solved it. No one's made a public announcement on that, but I'm giving the benefit of the doubt like somebody actually solved it. They were able to connect with enough people from the different college campuses or get the QR codes, if you will, and were able to get that money, if you will. And the same thing is happening with these current ones. The current university one, that wallet address hasn't been drained yet. There's one attached to it, 0.05, which around Bitcoin prices right now, it's not the initial $500 promise, but around 400, if you will. you know, again, if you go on the campuses and find the QR codes and then piece them together, you'll be able to obtain the wallet. I'm just hoping sometime, maybe over the weekend or soon, there'll be like another real legitimate puzzle to solve. As far as unsolved puzzles go, you still got the Earth Key, the Checkered Bird Key, the Ladder to the United Key, or keys that people haven't solved for yet. Pretty much everything is still available that's been released since the Checkerboard Key, which is July 27th. So there's still a lot of keys for people to solve, and just in general, a lot of keys that people can solve available on their site that you can do on their own and rack up if they're just first-time comers. There's also some of those expired keys have been publicly disclosed, so people can still rack those up into their key links. So people can still participate in this game and still solve it. But I think it's just more has reached a level of hobby instead of just like something you constantly do at this point, because just the way the clues have been released is just is not an active level engagement like it was when it was initially launched. And I don't know what that will mean for the rest of the game as it progresses. It'll be interesting to see, you know, a year from now what the status, if anything, of this game goes. I'm going to still keep doing these videos, but I think I'm not going to do Happy Clue Days anymore. I'm just going to do weekly ones and summarize what has been going on a weekly basis, just because the level of progression the game has done. So that's it for this particular weekly hunt video. In the video, you're going to see some of the QR code for the Tezo mini hunt, the QR codes for the University 02 drop, the three QR codes that have been released so far for that. I think it's a total of four locations for that particular one. And that's pretty much it. And the SC News Hunt showing the business card, what it looks like, which has had some issues. I know Mike calls it monocards, but they're like the business card ones. Not everyone's been able to get them. They were supposed to get them through the mail. That still hasn't happened for people. You basically have to physically find the game makers, which not everyone can do. So there's a little bit of, you know, knuffle about that. But that's it so far. That's all I have to say on this subject and what's going on with the hunt. Good luck to you hunters, Satoshi hunters out there. This is Ferocious Shy, Satoshi Stretcher Hunters.